All right, in this video, I'm going to talk about the absolute easiest way to train your dog to do anything, something I like to call passive training. So a lot of us like to talk too much to our dogs. On average, in the United States, most dogs know 10 commands and have 7 command words. Yes, I'm going to hold you right now. And so they get confused when we use come here, over here, here boy. We have all these different versions of the command. So we want to say just the command word. Now, passive training is basically just simply waiting for the dog to do the thing that you want it to do, just observing it until it does that, and then rewarding it. So if he comes over and sits next to me, I didn't ask him to sit, he just sits on his own. As soon as he sits, I pet him under his chin, and I say the word sit. Now, I like to pet a dog under his chin because when a dog feels good about itself, his nose is parallel to the ground or tilted upward. Those of you who have seen a dog that have stolen your underwear or shoes or something, run around the house with their nose in the air, they feel really good about themselves. I want him to feel good about the things we want him to do. So if he comes and sits down next to me, especially as a puppy, instead of trying to manipulate him into a sit, I'm just going to wait for him to sit. As soon as he does, I'm just going to pet him under his chin and just say the word sit. Every time he comes to you, pet him and say the word come. Every time he lays down, I like to use fun words, so my word is crash. Every time the dog lays down, I pet him and say crash. Now you can pet him anywhere you want, you just don't want to pet him on top of the head like this. This creates a nose down orientation. That's why I prefer to pet a dog under its chin. But you could scratch his butt or his side or anything else you want to as well. Just avoid doing this. So if every time he comes to you, you pet him and say, come, then when you actually need him to come, after a month or two of this, passive training usually takes 2 or 3 months, but eventually you say, come, he comes running because every time I come to him, I get a reward and a scratch behind the ear and I hear the word come. So first we should wait for the dog to do it and just reward them for what I call desired actions or behaviors. The same way if you clear the table, your mom gives you like a piece of chocolate cake or makes a big deal out of it because she hopes you clear the table again in the future. We want him to do things like sit, lay down, come to us. So any of these things that he does on a regular basis, if it's something we want him to do, every time he barks, if you say speak right afterwards. After you do it enough, you can say speak and he'll bark because now he's associated the two things together. Passive training is the easiest way to train your dog. It is so easy that I get a lot of people that disregard it and think it's not effective. It is extraordinarily effective. It just takes a habit for the human, and it will take the human about a month, I'm almost done, buddy, to get into a habit of doing that. So if every time he sits next to you, we don't want to have a wiggle. That would not be inappropriate. We could do that if you wanted to. But so anytime he sits, pet him and say sit, not good sit, not go potty, not his name, just sit. And not sit, sit, come, crash, whatever the words are. I taught my dog to stretch this way. Every time he stretches, pet him and say stretch, not good say stretch, and he'll stretch 10 times in a row. This is the easiest way to train your dog. It's what I like to call passive training.